You've heard it for years. The better you dress at work, the better you'll be perceived and the quicker you'll advance. To learn more about the importance of dressing well at the office, we spoke to a veteran human resources consultant.
Good, bad, right, or wrong, I have seen numerous instances where people got promoted that tended to dress better. People don't realize how important dressing is. I think we tend to think, oh, it's dumb, it's really not that important, who cares? Well, it's kind of like a resume. With clothing, it's the very first impression someone will get of you before you even have a chance to open your mouth.
For an insider's take on the right outfits for your profession, we spoke to a fashion representative at Theory's flagship store in New York City.
For men dressing in the corporate setting, I think a suit is always the best option. Here we have a dark navy suit. A dark suit's great just because it's really versatile and you'll always be able to wear it, whether it's for an interview, a board meeting, or any work-appropriate occasion. For a man to dress in the less corporate setting, I think separates are a great way to go. For example, here we have a navy cardigan with a button down and a tie, and you can really wear it without the tie if you want to for a less corporate look. Wearing the khaki pant with any sort of button down is a great option for casual dressing at the office. It's put together, but it's still relaxed. If you're questioning something that you want to wear and you're not sure if it's right, it probably isn't. If it's too shiny, if it's too tight, if it's too big, I probably just wouldn't recommend wearing it. For women dressing in a corporate setting, I would recommend a suit. Here we have a great fitted blazer, a button-down shirt, and a trouser pant. It's really put together, it's easy, and it looks really professional at the same time. But another option, if you don't want to wear a suit, is separates. Something like a great cardigan like this, with a button-down shirt and a pencil skirt, is still professional, but a little bit more relaxed and great for the office. Another casual option at the office is a pair of khaki pants. We have these straight leg pants that are great with a little tie neck top like this for a little novelty and a little fashion, but still work appropriate. Two other great casual options are shift dresses. What's great about shift dresses is that you can wear them underneath the blazer to work for an interview, or you can wear them just as they are. This one is great with a white button down underneath it, or this one's great too, just alone. Some fashion faux pas for women to look out for in the workplace are really anything that's too much of anything. Whether it's too short, too tight, too revealing, too low cut, you should really stay away from wearing anything like that.
I definitely think one should be thinking about wearing your best for an interview. I go by the rule, you're better off to tend to be a little bit more conservative in an interview than to go the other way around, unless you know specifically that they're looking at you for your creativity. Say you were going to interview in an advertising agency that's hiring you to be a creative person. There, you may decide to be a little bit more outlandish because that's what they're hiring you to do. The important part here is to be appropriate for the setting you're in.